Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for coming to this final keynote presentation where we are thrilled to announce a new product from VMware, the likes of which you've never seen before anywhere in the market. That's right, folks, we're here today to announce Cornet Flakes from VMware, the one breakfast cereal that people will use to put nutrition in their bellies. Digestion ready for breakfast and scale across all of your dietary needs. How can you be sure that this is original? Well, I'm glad you asked. It's so original, it even says so on the box. If you'd like to know more, come to our website and sign up to be notified when we finish building it. Are you excited? Let me hear you scream louder. Woo! I said, are you excited? I'm excited. Are you excited? Okay, whatever. Thanks for coming. Good night. Do you ever read The Onion? Back in 2004, when Gillette had the Mach 3 razor with three blades, and Schick came out with the Quattro four-blade razor, The Onion ran an article that was supposed to be written by James Kiltz, the CEO of Gillette. Now, I can't quote the article because it's totally NSFW, but it jokes about how Gillette responded to the Quattro by going from three blades to five blades, skipping four blades altogether. They still don't have a four-blade razor. The article asks a rhetorical question that has stuck with me for years, and the events of this past week made me think of it again. You all know that I'm a Rancher user and a huge fan of everything they create. I'm fortunate to have a professional relationship with them, but they don't sponsor this channel or pay for these videos. I've been building internet infrastructure since 1996, and during that time I've used everything from physical hardware to virtual solutions from VMware and Citrix, as well as open source solutions like Xen and Proxmox. For container management, I've researched products from Kubler, Pivotal, Red Hat, and others, and I always come back to Rancher. It does everything that I need it to do. Last week, VMware announced Tanzu Mission Control, their upcoming solution for managing Kubernetes clusters running all over the place. On the one hand, it's nice to see a nod from VMware. Shang Liang, Rancher's CEO, wrote a blog article talking about how this further validates that businesses are deploying multiple clusters and they're looking for tools to manage them. Developers are looking for ways to interact with Kubernetes clusters via APIs, and they want features like cluster deployment, while operations teams are looking for ways to provide a safe environment that doesn't slow developers down with onerous policy. That's great. Back in 2017, Rancher decided to abandon the custom scheduler that it had been building since 2014, going all in on Kubernetes. Rancher saw that Kubernetes was the path to success for containers in the enterprise, and even though it royally pissed off paying customers who used the old scheduler, Rancher stuck to their guns. When Rancher 2 came out, it had been rewritten to run inside of Kubernetes, making it a core piece of how Kubernetes operates. That in turn gave it tremendous power to deploy and manage clusters. Since then, Rancher has added valuable features around day two operations, backups, monitoring, multi-cluster solutions, security, global policies, edge deployments, hosted Kubernetes providers, and more. These are things that Kubernetes doesn't do natively. They're things that you need to have in your cluster, and if you're like most people, they're things that you aren't being paid to figure out. Use Rancher, and you don't have to figure it out. Build your apps with Rio, run them in Kubernetes on K3S or RKE, manage your clusters with Rancher. People who know nothing about Kubernetes are still able to safely deploy workloads in the cluster. Now, beyond validating the market, I was disappointed to see VMware tooting their horn like they came up with a new idea. VMware created Cloud Foundry. EMC bought Pivotal Labs in 2012. EMC is or was a majority stakeholder in VMware. In 2013, EMC and VMware spun Pivotal Software out as a new company and tasked it with selling Cloud Foundry to enterprises. And then, of course, VMware just bought Pivotal back at a discount after their stock tanked. Why did the stock tank? Because Pivotal had what analysts called a train wreck of a quarter, demonstrating that they're having a harder time selling a legacy PaaS solution like Cloud Foundry into enterprises that want Kubernetes. Before you flood the comments with cries of, "Oh, PKS," consider that PKS is nothing more than Kubernetes with the Kubernetes dashboard, except you have to go through five layers of bloat to deploy it. It's one of the worst Kubernetes solutions available. Yet VMware's presentation talked about how Pivotal has been at the forefront of an application transformation. Of course they're going to say that. It doesn't matter how dysfunctional a person is, their mother is always going to love them. So let's run through a list of what their new Tanzu Mission Control is supposed to do, and you tell me if you think that they've created something new and awesome.
I am thrilled to also announce VMware Tanzu Mission Control, the one product enterprises will use to manage their Kubernetes clusters. Enterprise grade, providing the control and visibility necessary for production at scale deployments.
Ooh, a buzzword sandwich. Yummy. People are going to use the solution that solves their problem. It's true that some people will use the solution that's most readily available, or the solution that ships with the other products that they're already using. Just look at browsers for a clear demonstration of that. Now, do you know what shadow IT is? Shadow IT is the cloud footprint a business has that they don't know about. It exists because people spin up their own services to do what they need to do, and they do it outside of the visibility and control of the IT department. Statistics show that shadow IT represents more than 90% of a business's IT footprint, so clearly, people are going to do whatever they want. Just because VMware says that it's the one product that everyone is going to use means nothing. Just because they say that it's enterprise grade doesn't mean that it is. Compare that to Rancher, who has over 20,000 deployments on 6 continents. More than 300 enterprise customers pay for a subscription that gets them access to support for Rancher, Kubernetes, Docker, Prometheus, Grafana, and other cloud-native technologies. Those customers span every vertical from finance to healthcare to government and military. Rancher doesn't have to tell you that their software is enterprise grade. Their customers say it.
Can I really manage all my Kubernetes clusters through Tanzu Mission Control?
No matter where they are, we can help you out.
vSphere and PKS?
Of course.
And public cloud and private cloud?
Yep.
And the native services of EKS and Microsoft AKS and Google GKE?
That's right. We can help you out there too. You got it, Pat.
We got it all.
So Tanzu Mission Control really brings us full circle.
Did any of you notice the dramatic pause for applause that never came? Those poor guys. Why didn't they say more than, we can help you out? What does that mean? Rancher already works in all of the places that VMware says Tanzu Mission Control is going to work. vSphere? Check. PKS? Check. Public cloud? Check. Private cloud? Check. EKS, AKS, GKE, import running clusters, Rancher really does have all of those bases covered, and it will do more than just help you out. It will truly help keep you free. Hang on to that idea, because I'm going to come back to it.
It brings developers and operators close together with one platform.
Developers and operators have been at war since the dawn of technology. Developers just want to ship code. Operators want to build things and make them secure. Those two things will forever be at odds, but Kubernetes really does make it possible for DevOps to work. It creates a place where operators create environments and deploy tools that developers can integrate into their workflows. It's not all hugs and kumbaya, but it's progress. What's missing from Kubernetes that might make it easier for developers to do their work? They need access to things outside of the cluster, things that deploy and interact with clusters via API calls. Rancher has always had this. Rancher is an API-driven product. Even the entire user interface makes API calls to do what it has to do. There's a CLI that wraps kubectl if you want access to things like cluster deployment, user management, or other wrapping functionality from outside the UI. Anyone with the right level of access can provision clusters from within Rancher. It's trivial to stand up clusters via API calls from Jenkins, Drone, or other CI systems, deploy apps into them, perform user acceptance tests or other real-world testing, and then tear them down. Except for the user that does the actual testing, the entire process can be completely automated.
Operators can provision clusters directly from Mission Control, and then they can set policy across things like access, backup, security, and more.
Rancher was the first product to do global policy management of Kubernetes clusters. You plug Rancher into a backend identity provider like GitHub or Active Directory or Keycloak or one of a list of other providers, and you instantly have access to all those users and groups for policy assignment. It has RBAC roles at the global, cluster, and project levels. It consolidates namespaces into projects to reduce the risk of human error when applying security policies across multiple namespaces. It has pod security policies at the global level too, so you can define what a cluster can and cannot do and then apply changes uniformly across your entire cluster landscape. Clusters deployed with Rancher are automatically backed up to local storage, and you can change that to an S3 compatible endpoint via an API call or a few clicks in the UI.
Meanwhile, developers get the freedom to innovate, to do their best work within the guardrails set up by those operators. They get APIs, self-service, and a simpler way to collaborate.
Developers hate when you tell them that they need guardrails, and they hate when you imply that they're ever doing anything other than their best work. If you're a developer and you're watching this, you should be offended that VMware thinks you need to be treated like a child. Now, everyone needs guidelines. Operations teams aren't superior to developers, nor the other way around. Cooperation requires communication. It requires education. It requires a conversation between everyone involved, and it's going to fail if everyone is not committed to finding a solution that works. Rancher can be that solution, but it's not the right solution for everyone. The people who build it know that, It's a solution. They think it's a good solution, and so do I. Thousands of deployments use it successfully, but it's up to you to decide if it works for you and for your team. Now let's burn through the rest of this list of features.
Create a Kubernetes cluster or attach an existing cluster to Tanzu Mission Control. It doesn't matter where that cluster is located, in your data center, on public cloud, or at the edge. You can bring all your clusters together and manage them with consistency and confidence.
Rancher can deploy clusters in hosted Kubernetes providers. It can stand up cloud compute instances in public or private clouds and then deploy Kubernetes into them and wire them back to the management server. It can deploy Kubernetes into any environment with a supported version of Docker. With solutions like K3S, Rancher can deploy Kubernetes into resource-constrained locations that may be disconnected from the internet or function on low bandwidth links. It really doesn't matter where those clusters are.
Monitor the health of all your clusters in one place.
Rancher deploys Prometheus and Grafana along security boundaries. This means that users can only see metrics for the projects that they have access to. Cluster admins can see information for all workloads in the cluster and the cluster itself. Global admins can see everything. Each of these groups accesses their information through the Rancher UI, that single pane of glass that shows everything.
Enforce policies to determine who can access clusters.
Check.
How traffic is routed to them.
This is a vague statement that could mean almost anything. I don't know what they're claiming they can do. I mean, maybe Tanzu Mission Control can manage cloud provider infrastructure and change security policies, route tables, VPC network ACLs, and do so uniformly across every cloud provider that exists. I'm guessing no. Maybe they mean that they can control how traffic is routed inside of the cluster. That makes a little bit more sense. That sounds like service mesh to me, in which case, check. Or maybe it's network policies off the CNI driver, in which case, check.
Policies can be enforced at a cluster-wide and an application-specific level.
This can also mean different things. Rancher does policy enforcement at a global cluster and project or namespace level, along with network policies. It can do full single cluster multi-tenancy where multiple parties on the same cluster have no idea that anyone else is sharing it. It's extremely comprehensive, and so I'm just gonna say, check.
You can give developers more independence with centralized authentication.
Check.
API-driven workflows.
Check.
And managed namespaces.
Check.
You can give developers self-service access to the resources they need to test and run containerized applications on any infrastructure.
Check.
Move with zero risk of lock-in. It's worth repeating. All clusters are welcome here.
Check. Rancher wants you to use the product because it provides value. It's 100% free and open source. You can stop using it at any time, and all of your clusters will continue to run fine. You'll just access them with kubectl. It truly is the definition of no lock-in.
It's not an act, it's showtime.
VMware is not altruistic. They created Cloud Foundry and Pivotal. They're gobbling up companies like Heptio and Bitnami, trying to secure as much as they can in the ground war for Kubernetes territory. They are a massive enterprise, and they create value by acquiring customers and holding on to them. Their products are the very definition of lock-in. What reason would they have for creating a product that doesn't lock you in? I think this is a Hail Mary pass for them. They need to reinvent themselves as a company that is relevant in a marketplace that breathes Kubernetes, because if they don't, they die. Maybe Tanzu will truly be open and free, unicorns and rainbows and squirrels that bake cookies. I don't know, but I'm not holding my breath. We won't know how they plan to monetize Tanzu Mission Control or the rest of the Tanzu Vapor line until they get around to releasing it. Do you want to be the first to try it? It's going to lack features. It's going to have bugs. It's going to do terrible things that you can't imagine because it's untried and untested. And they're asking you to put your production environment under its control. Your baby. Your income stream. If the TMC feature list sounds interesting, check out Rancher. It has everything that you want, and if it doesn't, it's a company that is close enough to its customers to build the features that the customers need. Back in 2004, that Onion article asked the question, why innovate when we can follow? It seems like a lot of companies see a successful product and create a Me Too product to capture some of the market instead of building something new. Following is safe. Someone already paved the way. And that's what you're looking at here. VMware has built a product that you can't use yet, that claims to offer a fraction of the feature set of a product that has already been on the market for more than 2 years, and they come out on stage and present it like, ta-da, look what we invented. A company like Rancher has innovation at its core. It takes risks. It pushes the limits. It redefines what's possible. It does it so that you can have the future that you want as soon as possible. It comes to you and it says, here's something that we made for you, and we think that you'll like it. VMware has a vested interest in keeping you locked into their platform. They want to keep you on a short leash so that they can sell you more VMware services. Remember earlier when I said that Rancher keeps you free? Rancher doesn't sell any other products. Everything is free and open source. An enterprise subscription gets you support because we all know that Kubernetes can sometimes be difficult to work with. But all of the products that Rancher creates exist to make Kubernetes better. Rancher doesn't have any other horse in the race other than to help you have a better Kubernetes experience across the board, in all clusters, with any provider, with no hidden agenda masked by a pretense of just being nice. That's the company that I want to work with. If you're already a Rancher user, you know what I'm talking about. But if you're not a Rancher user yet, head over to rancher.com and see what you're missing. It's open source, so there's no risk in taking it for a spin. As for me, I'll be back next week with a complete Rancher deployment from zero to HA Rancher with an HA cluster running in EC2, and we'll start using that to compare what other companies are offering for their Kubernetes management experience. So if you're down for more honesty, click the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and please share this video with your friends. If you want to hit me up directly, you can do so on Twitter or LinkedIn or in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.